come on.
Wish you all peace and goodwill. You can sing and hug your jingle.
love and truly trust in the Lord and how we love and care for one another as brothers and sisters in Christ, as Jesus commanded us to. In fact, he said to love your enemies. Wow. Boy, that's a rough one right there. That doesn't sit well. But anyway.
Amen. But that's too bad. I'm always so glad when that song is over, because it's like in the wrong key for my voice.
Yeah, you sound terrible.
But you know, we want to sing it because we know you guys like it. So, yeah.
Well,
yeah.
My mother.
Or hopefully did. Hopefully somebody does.
Andy's song.
Yeah. No, so we have a really interesting topic today. And I'm I'm just so glad for the Word of God, because it really opens up your eyes and okay, I was going to use that, but that's okay.
Oh, okay.
That's okay. This is fine.
Mm-hmm.
This is fine. So I love this because I've really never heard this preached on. And
no.
So I'm excited. I was really, really excited doing this outline and doing this, finding these scriptures because.
Well, let me set this up a little bit, because I believe that a lot of things in Christendom in America is that we don't read the Bible for ourselves. There's your major problem. That's a major
really
pandemic. There's your pandemic.
That's a pandemic. Exactly. Right. Really, that comes, I really believe that comes out of Catholicism, because definitely you're not encouraged to read the Bible for yourself.
No,
because
the priest
Church,
is the one
that
reads
priest
it.
Is the one, you know, oh, you won't understand it.
Right.
And
he doesn't want you to understand it.
It is confusing when the catechism goes against the Word of God.
The
so
catechism.
That would cause confusion.
What's a catechism? Is that like Eva? We're not trying to be mean or facetious. The reality is this, is that we are ignorant in the Word of God. All of us have been, me included. I don't exclude myself from that group of people, because I didn't read the Bible for myself.
Right. Right.
I waited to hear T.D. Jakes preach
it. Us too.
Or somebody else to preach it. Or, you know, oh, it was so powerful. It came out of his mouth. No, the power is in the Bible.
The power is
not in the man.
God.
Not in the person.
And doing it.
Right, and obeying it.
Obeying it, yeah.
And guys, you know, so we came up because of songs, because of music. Because I heard an artist singing this song, and I didn't quite understand it. And Veronica's going to explain it scripturally.
This is a phrase that we've been hearing.
No,
for
yeah, it's not just
years.
Yeah, but it became up from a singer, and they sing about this fire raining down on us. Now hold on. Do we want fire to rain down on us, Veronica? I mean, it'll burn my lovely hair.
All right, so let's get into this. Let's get into this.
Well, I mean, think about it.
Yeah.
I mean, but guys, I mean. This is the things that we're being taught through songs, because there is songs that impact us. They've impacted our lives, you know, and, you know, just like a song that impacted mine, you know, with Running Back to You, Jesus. That was a song that impacted my life. Now, it's irrelevant about who sang it. The point is that song impacted my life. So music is very impactful. It can change a whole atmosphere. It can change everything, but you got to be careful about what you're listening to. And it has to line up with what she's going to teach you right now. Veronica?
We're teaching.
Right.
So I just opened this up by saying that there are certain phrases. I was thinking about certain things that we hear in church that are not always biblical or scriptural when you really look at the Word of God. And we just tend to repeat.
Yeah.
Just like were you saying, what the preacher says or what each other, what we say in church. We tend to repeat what one another is saying.
We're parakeets.
You know? And again, is it biblical? Is it scriptural? Or is it denominational? You know? Is it coming from another place? Okay? So the best way to know this is to study the Word of God for yourself. So we say it all the time here, study the Bible for yourself, to have your own understanding of words within Scripture. So like King James Version Bible has really changed my life. Using that along with the Strong's Concordance, that has really changed my life because it's given me understanding what you preached on, Angelo, understanding of the Word. So we're talking about the word fire, the meaning of fire. There are over 500 references to fire in Scripture. So this is obviously something important for us to understand, okay? So one of the meanings, so I found 5 different meanings of the word fire, because it's not always used, you know, a fire in the chimney, you know, or, you know, light a fire in the woods. So it's not always literal fire, but sometimes it's used figuratively. So I found 5 meanings of what the word fire means. And this, guys, this is going to affect, just like Angela said, the music we listen to and again, our denominational, the doctrines that come from denomination.
Correct.
And not necessarily from the Word of God. So number one, fire means judgment. The Strong's Concordance says figuratively, this is figurative, used for the anger and wrath of God.
Wow.
Fire and burning are used in Hebrew, okay, in the Hebrew language, to designate any destruction, whether of men or things. The first scripture that is used with the word fire is Genesis 19:24. Then the Lord rained upon Sodom. Guys, get your Bibles out. Genesis 19:24. Then the Lord rained upon Sodom and upon Gomorrah, brimstone and fire from the Lord out of heaven.
First reference to fire. Burning 2 cities.
Yeah.
Because of what? Because of partying? No, because of what? Because of sin. I'm telling you guys.
Yes.
Guys, this is... It can't be made up. The word doesn't make itself up. It's the word of God.
That's right.
Okay, it burned because of sexual immorality. Okay, that's why it burned.
That's right.
Okay, and I don't understand what people don't understand. What is there not to understand about it?
Amen.
I mean, come on, guys. Yeah. Is this being mean or hateful? No, it's telling you the truth. The truth is, that's what happened. So why in the world would you sing Rain Down Fire on Me if that's what you're celebrating?
So I want to point this out, that the world, this reference is so incredibly important, because this is how the world is going to actually end.
Hello.
Because Jesus said in the days of when the Son of Man comes, it's going to be as the days of Noah and the days of Lot.
Correct.
So, and so here's this scripture is what is going to happen in the last day or the day of the Lord. God calls it the day of the Lord. 2 Peter 3, 10 through 12. But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, for those who are not expecting it, in the which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat, and the earth also, and the works that are therein shall be burned up.
That's right.
Seeing then that all these things shall be dissolved, what manner of persons ought we ye to be in all holy conversation and godliness, looking for and hasting unto the coming of the day of God, wherein the heavens shall, wherein the heavens being on fire shall be dissolved, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat. So this Correct. Is exactly what is going to happen.
Right. It's prophesied.
So in other words, heaven and earth, Jesus said heaven and earth shall pass away.
That's
this
right.
is how the heavens and the earth are going to pass
That's
away.
That's right.
And also, come on. All the works. Works of wow. what? The works of men.
Of religion.
That are, yeah, could be any dead works.
That's what this music meant to me. It was a religious ceremony in a song. It just celebrates religion. It's not rightfully dividing the word of God in spirit and in truth. There's no understanding. Okay, if I tell you, oh, rain down elephants, well, why would I want an elephant to rain on top of me? I mean, you might as well be singing rain down an elephant.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, guys, this is religion. It's religion, and that's the TBNites. It's those who watch Christian television, Christian perspective on social media, and that all they get is religion because they're not encouraging you to divide the word of God rightfully. They're not telling you to go read your Bible. They're not encouraging you. I was never encouraged. I promise you. I was part of that whole scene. We were part of it all. We experienced it all. It wasn't like we're gossiping about this. This is a reality.
And I just want to clarify, when you say religion, you mean a false form of religion.
A false.
Because there
Correct.
Is pure religion.
Absolutely.
And that is the word
well,
of God.
Well, somebody's got to be right and somebody's got to be wrong.
Yeah, unfortunately.
That's the way it rolls.
Yeah, that's the way it is. Yeah, so guys.
Because the Bible is not up for multiple interpretations.
That's right.
It's not my interpretation. Okay, it's not Veronica's interpretation. It's God's interpretation and through revelation and understanding of the word.
Yeah,
that's what we get
right.
when we're in the word. But when you're listening to music and all you see is these people with their pretty faces and their nice outfits and stuff like that singing foolishness, guys, we've got to stop it. It's not helping our spirit man. It's not. It's not helping
so
us.
So here's a really interesting scripture, and this is Luke 9. Again, fire representing judgment is one of the meanings of the word fire in the Bible.
Well, do what you wrote there.
Luke 9.
Would you write that?
Do not call down fire.
Do Here, not call down fire.
Here's why Jesus said, do not call down fire. And it's in Luke 9. 54 through 56, and it says, and when his disciples James and John saw this, they said, Lord, wilt thou that we command fire to come down from heaven and consume them, even as Elijah did? But Jesus turned and rebuked them and mm-hmm. said, ye not know what manner of spirit ye are. Is not come to destroy men's lives, but to save them. So he's,
wow.
this is a reference to 1 Kings, I'm sorry, 2 Kings, when Elijah called down fire
right.
from heaven. And
if you burn in fire, will you be in heaven?
Wow. Oh, yes. Right.
Sorry.
Exactly.
Guys.
Exactly.
Please.
Yep. Because when Elijah called down fire from heaven, it was to these men's destruction. Yeah.
You know what, guys?
He came against
I hate
the Lord.
To use the word, but it's ignorance. That's what we are. When we don't rightfully divide the word of God, we are ignorant. And so that we just follow every lead and every trail that looks and sounds good to us, but only it's going to lead us to the broad way that leads to destruction not the narrow. Guys, these folks have a motive in mind, and it's not your soul. It's your money. That's what it is. That's what American church has come to. Money. I mean, you see it all through, I see it all through the city here. It's all about their lights and the money and their buildings and their all that other stuff that doesn't amount to anything at the end of the day. Is that saving souls? A temple over there down the street that seats 5,000 people and you're leading them to the Broadway that leads to destruction? How is that helping people?
Right. And the question is, okay, well, why was Elijah able to call down fire from heaven? But Jesus is telling his disciples, no, don't call down fire from heaven. So this is, excuse me, this is just what I think. The reason Jesus didn't allow his disciples to call down fire from heaven is that Jesus came down heaven.
Come on.
To in the flesh, okay, which not everybody believes, in the flesh to be the sacrifice, to be the one and only sacrifice for our sins in order to appease the wrath of God until the appointed time, giving men a chance to repent.
Amen.
Until the appointed time.
Correct.
The day of the Lord. Day of the Lord.
Okay, if he didn't,
fire is going to come down.
If Jesus didn't come down in the flesh, how would they have received him when he came down? As what? He had to come down in the flesh.
That's right.
He had to come down in our likeness, in his likeness. He came down. We're in his likeness. He's not in our likeness. We're in the likeness of God the Father, right? So Jesus came as the Son, as a human being on earth, and he suffered.
Yeah.
Somebody at work tried to trick me. Go, what's the? Do you know what the gospel is? I go, yeah. Do you know? It's the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. That's the gospel. Do you know it, sir? No, I think you don't. That's why you asked me. So now you know. Okay. Jesus came and he died for your sins. Okay, so that you wouldn't have to have fire rain down upon you.
That's right.
Guys.
Or burn in the lake of fire. Right, exactly. So now here's another very, very interesting scripture. And it's in Revelation. Revelation 13:13 and verse 14. And this is talking about the beast, he or the Antichrist, he doeth great wonders so that he maketh fire come down from heaven on the earth in the sight of men and deceiveth them that dwell on the earth by the means of those miracles which he had power to do in the sight of the beast. So this is the second beast. And so, in other words, the Antichrist makes fire come down, and it says, from heaven on the earth in the sight of men. What is Thessalonians talks about how the son of perdition will work and by lying wonders. So this is going to be a lying wonder.
That's right.
That the Antichrist calls down fire from heaven. Again, Jesus said, don't call down fire.
So why would you do it?
Right.
Why would you sing it?
Right.
And then, you know, it's because this person is so famous, right, that other churches follow suit. See, because they don't have a song in their mouth, they have to use the songs from these other people. Okay, when Jesus said, the word says, sing unto me a new song. So don't sing the songs of the popular singers. How about what's in your heart? See, I don't understand that whole premise that you have to have somebody else write a song for you. Just sing a song unto the Lord. Sing a melody. It may be a good melody. I may not like it, but the Lord likes it, and that's all that matters. Doesn't matter if I like it. Doesn't matter if you like my melodies. Doesn't matter. we're singing unto the Father, okay? And he's pleased with us.
Yeah.
That's all. Yeah. We're not trying to please man when we sing.
Amen.
Okay? That's the reality. We're not looking for the praise of man. We want the praise of God. That's what we want. We want his encouragement. Okay? And he encourages us, Veronica.
Amen.
Okay? That's and the thing is that I try to get a perspective of the song and that where they were going with this song as far as Pentecost and as far as the revival. It's like rain down fire for a revival.
Okay, so you would just want to go there?
Yeah,
you
I do.
Want to go there right now?
I do want to go, because then we're going to
okay,
close
cause
out.
I'm not talking about a song. I'm talking about things that you hear in church.
Right.
And they use this phrase.
The phrase, exactly.
It's like, wait, where is this coming from? And is it from the Word of God? So you're talking about Acts 2, 3, and 4. And
correct.
Therapy. So, okay. So hold on a second. All right. So we talked about how fire is judgment.
Right.
Now, fire is also representing the tongue. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I'm sorry. Let me just say this. Fire also represents sacrifice.
Correct.
The phrase through the fire, if you look up the phrase through the fire in Scripture, that's another song. Through the fire in Scripture, it is a reference to child sacrifice.
Wow.
Yeah, of Israel's worship of Baal and Molech, which is an abomination, of course, mm-hmm. to the Lord. Mm-hmm. 2 Kings 17:7 says, and they caused their sons and their daughters to pass through the fire and used divination and enchantments and sold themselves to do evil in the sight of the Lord to provoke him to anger. So that is another meaning of a fire.
Right.
So the third meaning of fire, and this is where getting to what you're talking about, this scripture that you're talking about, is the meaning of fire, this is so crazy, is the tongue. Yes, the tongue. So James 3 says, the tongue is a fire,
mm-hmm.
a world of iniquity. So is the tongue.
Why do I have to rain down fire if my tongue, if the fire is right in my tongue? Why do I have to sing about raining down fire on me, on God's people? Why would you do that?
It says, so the tongue is among our members that it defiled the whole body and setteth on fire the course of nature and is set on fire of hell. So in other words, the power of your tongue to give life,
mm-hmm.
to either give life or to destroy. That's the fire that James is talking about. The power to preach the gospel and give life to others because you're leading them into eternal life, or the opposite and lead them to hell. So Strong's Concordance says, as though both itself, the tongue on fire and setting other things on fire, partly by reason of the fiery spirit which governs it, partly by reason of the destructive power it exercises, since fire disorganizes and sunders things joined together and compact. It is used to symbolize dissension,
mm-hmm.
which dissension is a disagreement that leads to discord.
There you go.
Yes.
And I just, on a side note, if you're going to rebuke God's people, have the word in your mouth. You're going to go on social media, you don't even know somebody, and you rebuke them or you say outlandish things that you have no idea what you're talking about, yet you're on your computer and you just spew out stuff, okay? Have the word of God in your mouth. Have scripture ready to back up your offensive words towards somebody, no matter who it is. You know, we've received some nasty stuff. And I understand, you know, why people are offended, because they themselves are living in these, in their life, that that is, again, they're not reading the Bible.
So Isaiah,
I have to go there. Okay.
Isaiah 30:27 says, "Behold, the name of the Lord cometh from far, burning with his anger, and the burden thereof is heavy. His lips are full of indignation, and his tongue as a devouring fire." So again, the tongue, and in this reference is God's tongue as a devouring fire. Mm-hmm. So moving on to the scripture that you're saying, Acts 2:3-4.
Let's go there, please.
And it says, appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of, remember that, as of fire. So not actual fire,
right,
but as of fire. And it sat upon each of them, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. So now here's my notes.
And you've heard that expression, Holy Ghost and far.
Okay, that's okay. And I, yeah.
Yeah.
All right. So, well, I want to comment on this.
Yeah, stay here.
First. Okay. So the speaking of tongues, okay? Tongues as of fire. So here it is. The speaking of tongues here is a precursor to the preaching of the gospel. If you read throughout the whole chapter of Acts, it's all leading up to preaching the gospel to the lost house of Israel.
Mm-hmm.
And they were very convicted, thank God, in that time about the crucifying of Jesus Christ.
But not today.
You know? Yeah. So the speaking of tongues is a precursor to the preaching of the gospel. So the Spirit, the Holy Spirit not only gives utterance to speak in other tongues, but for the preaching of the gospel. So the manifestation of the Holy Spirit is not only speaking in tongues, but is preaching the gospel and other gifts of the Spirit. So it says here, the cloven tongues like as of fire, okay, was the empowerment of the Holy Ghost for the preaching of the gospel. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right? So again, it wasn't just about speaking in tongues, because speaking in tongues is wonderful, but the preaching of the gospel is what gets people saved. Okay? So
wow.
It says here, so cloven, the word cloven means to, again, cleave asunder, cut in pieces, to be divided into opposing parts, to be at variance, in dissension. So that's what cloven means. And again, it's as of fire, so it wasn't actual fire.
Exactly.
Okay, as of fire.
Exactly. I mean, we've got to be clear. You know, when we're going to use religious terms, people, if you want to live in that religion world and you want to follow the religious folks.
I know. Keeps on doing that.
Religion.
But what I'm saying is the religious world.
If you're going to follow their traditions.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Then expect their results. Because you're going to get their results, because you want to rain down fire on somebody? It's coming. Don't worry. Okay? We're not going to do it here at Higher Place. I can promise you that.
Yeah. Yeah.
There'll be no raining down no fire in this house in the name of Jesus. Okay? No. In fact, I don't want to be here when Jesus comes and does what he needs to do.
That's right.
What he's prophesied to do.
That's right.
And guys,
the day of the Lord is coming.
The day of the Lord is coming, and that's why we have this service, is to prepare you for what is coming so that you'll have an understanding rather than, oh, I really don't know what's going on. You need to know what's going on spiritually.
Right.
You really do, guys. This is not poke fun at somebody because they got a Grammy for singing fire. Okay, no, that's nonsense. We all know what Grammys are. They're all bought anyway. They're not earned by any means. Does it make you the greatest singer in the world because you have 45 Grammys? You know, it doesn't. Okay, that's just the world system that promotes you. That's what it does. That's what the whole award banquet shows are, is to promote you. Okay, not Christ. So those who say, call themselves, oh, it's Christian awards. No, it's about you. We won an award, it was about Angelo and Veronica. It wasn't about Jesus Christ. That's why you don't see it up in our mantle anymore. That's why you won't see it in the mantle, because we're not led by man's approval. Okay, we want God's approval. That's why we do what we do here at Higher Place. We want you to know the truth. We want you to get clarity on everything that we're speaking so that you'll have understanding of it, so that you'll go, I get it. I get it. I get what they're saying. Okay? And if you don't reach out to us, we will get you the information. You need to have the information that's correct. You don't need information that's going to put you on some religious cruise ship somewhere, you know, la la land, okay, spiritually ignorant and oblivious. We need to wake up. Amen?
Amen, amen. So there is so much on this subject.
Yeah, we got to go.
I mean, oh my gosh. So we'll have to do a part two.
Yeah, absolutely.
Of this, because, I mean, we were going to talk about the Holy Ghost and fire.
Right. Well, that's, yeah.
You have to read the verses before that and the verse after that.
No, but that's not what we do. We read one scripture.
Yeah.
And we pull it out.
Yeah.
And we make it our own.
Yeah.
Put it in context of when it was said, where it was said, who it was said to. Okay, get it all
the
information
that led up to that.
Exactly.
That led up to,
and the events that it's going to.
That is going to, yeah.
That's exactly. The prophecy of the Word of God. Yeah. Where it's going, okay?
That's right.
Guys.
That's right.
We love you. We care for your soul. We cry for your soul.
We're
believing for you. We're believing that, you know what? Don't get caught up in this mess of Christmas that's marketed, okay? Because it's supposed to be the most joyous time of the year. And I found it, even as a child, it was the saddest time of the year. There was a heaviness to it. There was a heaviness because it's not God. Okay? Okay, we don't celebrate Jesus Christ. We celebrate Macy's. And we celebrate all those other places. Yeah.
That's right.
I mean, guys, let's be real. If we're going to be real, let's be real. Let's be honest. So,
and I just want to say that this fire coming down from heaven, again, is going to happen in the day of the Lord. So, guys, don't be scared.
No.
Be prepared that you repent today. Believe the gospel of Jesus Christ. Again, the gospel of Jesus Christ, just what you said, Jesus died for your sins, rose again on the third day. That is the gospel of Jesus Christ for your sins.
That's right.
Okay? So
that's right.
Ask God to grant you repentance, because granting you repentance means turning away from your sins, because that's what brings destruction. That's what's bringing fire down from heaven. The sins and rebellion of man for all these centuries, and man still won't repent.
Nope.
That's what's bringing destruction and this curse that's going to devour the earth, as the book of Isaiah says, okay? Because of man's sin and unwillingness to repent. So guys, this is the most important thing. Last week we talked about the one thing that is needed. That is the one thing that is needed.
Yeah.
Faith in Jesus Christ, turning away from your sin and keeping that faith and trust in Jesus Christ always.
We love you. Have a wonderful week. God bless you.